5G, we can expect speeds of up to 1.6 gigabits per second, which is just insane. So is it worth spending the extra money to get yourself a 5G phone? Can you use the 5G phone to replace your slow router and then dump your sluggish ISP altogether? There's a bunch of stuff that you need to know about 5G first, which is exactly what we're going to learn today. Okay, let's do this. Break it down, now, phone, gadget, apps, it's the Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, my name is Liron Segev, where I talk about Wi-Fi and gadget and tech tips and phones and how to. If you're into that kind of stuff, hit that subscribe button below and let's get on to today's show. So we know that 5G is the next generation tech that follows 4G, but it's a little bit more complicated than just that. And this is where we have to cut through all this marketing hype and really understand 5G. You see, the first thing you need to know is that not all 5G networks are the same. And this has a direct impact on your speed. Depending on your cellular carrier, they have a different implementation of 5G. And this impacts not only the availability of 5G, but its speed and actual usage. You see, when it comes to 5G, there are two groups, millimeter wave and sub-6 networks. So why does all this matter? And stick with me here. Well, millimeter wave is stunningly fast. It carries more data, greater bandwidth, but it has two major drawbacks. It requires the carrier to have physical mini cell sites, and you need to be in close proximity to one of those cell sites to really take advantage of that beautiful, insane 5G speeds. The other downside is that it has very limited ability to work through stuff. So if you're inside a home or inside your office or your car, or even if there's a tree between you and the mini cell sites, well, it just doesn't work. Now, sub-6 on the other hand, well, that travels a lot further, can pass through buildings, which means whether you're indoors or outdoors, you get a nice stable connection. However, well, the speed of the sub-6 network isn't so wow as the marketing would have you believe. So if your carrier has 5G, don't be impressed just yet. You see, if they use the millimeter wave and you don't live by one of those mini cell sites, you're probably only gonna get 4Gs anyway. Now, if they use the sub-6, more stable, more usage, but the speeds aren't stupidly fast. Now, of course, to take advantage of 5G, you also need 5G hardware. This is where the cell phone industry is having an absolute field day with these super fast 5G phones. I have the new Samsung Note 20 Ultra 5G. It's an awesome phone, can really do a lot, and it can also handle 5G. If I was on the Verizon network and used a 5G, which is millimeter wave, I would need to find a spot that's very close to the mini cell spot in order to get those speeds. However, since I'm connected to the T-Mobile speed and they use the sub-6, I don't need to be anywhere close to the tower, and luckily my area has got full 5G coverage. But what does that practically mean? Well, I'm gonna go test the T-Mobile 4G on the Pixel 4 XL and the 5G on the Note 20 Ultra 5G, and I'm expecting the results to be wow on the 5G. Now, to be clear, this is a layman's test. In other words, I'm taking two devices, I'm gonna run some speed tests, and I wanna understand what data I'm gonna get on 4G versus the 5G. This isn't done in a lab, this isn't under ideal conditions, but this is the average lay person who would get a phone and expect 5G speeds, expect to be blown away. But is that gonna happen? Well, we're gonna test that out now.
Okay, let's get some testing done. So 4G is on the left, 5G is on the right. I'm gonna connect to exactly the same Plano, Texas site using speedtest.net, and we're gonna run these tests consecutively 3 times. This way, we're gonna get a nice average. I will then also pick this up and move it to another site, which is a couple of feet away on the other side of the trampoline, to see if location makes any difference. So we can see the first set of tests, test 1, test 2, and test 3, and now we're going to get a nice average, and I will have everything summarized shortly, so don't worry about that. Let's move to a couple of feet away on the trampoline on the other side. Should this make any difference? Well, let's see. So again, phone on the left, 4G, phone on the right is 5G, speedtest.net, same location, same site that we're connecting to, running the test 3 times to get those averages. Test 1 is in. Obviously, this is in fast forward for those who don't know how speed test works, but this is in fast forward. I want to get those results. So test number 1, test number 2, Test number 3 is coming up, and then let's analyze the results. Right, the results are in. So, location number 1. 4G got 33.16 download, whereas 5G got 20.76 download. You can clearly see that 4G was better. Again, on the 4G, 11.13 on the upload, and 5G got 6.32. Again, 4G was better. Then when we moved a couple of feet to the left, things changed. On the 4G, on location number 2, the average was 38.1 on the download versus the 5G, which was 41.26 on the download. And upload, 9.73 on the 4G network, and then 5G, 5.20. So a whole mixed bag, and simply changing location by a couple of feet changes everything.
Okay, so let's go back to the original questions. Should you spend extra money on a 5G and replace your router from your ISP with a 5G hotspot? Well, as you can see from the various tests, 5G is ridiculously sensitive to your location. Moving it a couple of feet either way has a direct impact on the speed, whereas 4G was relatively consistent. 5G was sometimes faster than 4G, but not consistently faster every single time. There was also a lot of jitter on the 5G, whereas in the 4G, not so much. So you're probably going to get a better experience on that 4G. Now this is location specific, so you might have a completely different result, and I guess that's exactly my point. 5G isn't the same for everyone all of the time. Would I spend extra money right now on a 5G phone? No. Would I replace my home router with a 5G hotspot? Well, it depends. As I said before, if you run this test from your home and you get a nice faster speed than your ISP gives you, superb. Go ahead and replace your ISP with a 5G cell phone hotspot. Make sure you get an unlimited data plan that covers that hotspot, and then you are absolutely golden, way faster than your ISP. I'm glad devices like phones and routers and laptops are getting 5G built into them so they're future proof. Would I spend the money right now to get one of those devices and spend the extra money right now? Nope, I'm afraid it's just not there yet. I would love to know what you guys think. Let me know in the comments below. Check out more Wi-Fi tips and tricks down here. Hit the head below to subscribe if this is your first time. Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it, and I'll see you in those videos. Let's go.